Hello, good evening, and welcome to a new Azure vlog. In this one, I want to talk about security, and especially the security of your own Azure subscription. What I see at a lot of my customers is that they don't have something like multi-factor authentication enabled. They only log in with their username and password. And it can be quite riskful. Lots of people use the same password at multiple websites, and there are a lot of websites that actually have breaches or that have been compromised and credentials could have been stolen. So it's really important to verify that the user that is logging in to the Azure portal is really that user, really that person, that identity. And you can validate that by using multi-factor authentication. With multi-factor authentication, you're not only using a username and password, you are also using something else, something that's in the possession of only the identity that has the permissions to really log in or authenticate at the service that you want. In this case, the Azure portal. And that possession can be the mobile phone. We can send text messages with codes to that mobile phone, and the user has to enter these codes into a login form in order to authenticate. Two-factor authentication, you use your password and username, and aside of that, you also have your mobile phone. So let me show you in this Azure vlog how you can set up multi-factor authentication for the accounts that you use to log into Azure. And that can be the Azure portal, it can be PowerShell or any other tool that needs to interact with the Azure Resource Manager. But first, yeah, let's make a good cup of coffee. There's nothing better than Azure Vlog combining with coffee. I like it so much. But let's get into details. Let me show you how you can enable multi-factor authentication for accounts that you use to log in to the Azure portal. Multi-factor authentication is there not for free. You at least require a P1 Azure Active Directory license or at least an EMS E3 license. In this demo, I will show you how you can obtain a trial license and use those trial licenses on the accounts in your Azure Active Directory. To get the trial license, let's go to Azure Active Directory in the Azure portal. Let's go to licenses. Click on your product. Click on try/buy. And in my case, I will start a trial of an EMS E5 license. Click activate. And this will activate the trial for you. Okay, now let's assign the license to a user that needs to log into the Azure portal. In order to do so, let's go to licenses. Let's click on your purchased products. Let's go to the EMS E5 license, let's click on assign and assign this to my test user, Jan test user. Select the assignment options, let's leave them all turned on. In this case, I want to demonstrate all of things another vlog, so I already have these licenses enabled now. Let's click on assign. What you see is that there is an error. License cannot be assigned to a user without a usage location specified. In this case, I created this user and I have not specified in which location, what the usage location is for this user. So in order to specify it, let's go to the Azure Active Directory. Let's go to the user. And here at settings, we have the usage location. And as you can see, it's currently empty. We need to fill that in. This user is living in the Netherlands and he will also log in from the Netherlands. So we'll go for that. Here it is, Netherlands. Let's click on save. The user profile has been updated. So let's try to assign the license again. Let's go to your products. Click on the EMS license. Click on assign. Select the user. The assignment options, we leave them all turned on. Let's click on assign. And this time it went well. We have a green check mark. So now let's enable multi-factor authentication for this user. In order to do so, there are multiple ways. If you want to enable this for a single user, let's go to users. Let's go to multi-factor authentication. Let's click on my user and click on enable. Enable multi-factor authentication. And now multi-factor authentication has been enabled. The user, when he will log in, he will be prompted for his phone number, an alternate email address, etc. So let me show you how that is working. Let's go to portal.azure.com. Let's log in with jan.testuser at my domain. Next. Let's enter his email address. What you see over here is the form that there's more information required in order to enable the multi-factor authentication. Let's click on next. Let's select our country, that's the Netherlands. Okay, I've entered the phone number for this user. It's actually the phone number of this phone over here. And in this case, well, let Microsoft do a call to us. Click next. So now they will call me. Let's accept this call.
Thank you for using the Microsoft sign-in verification system. Please press the pound key to finish your verification.
Okay, let's click pound.
Your sign-in was successfully verified. Goodbye.
Bye-bye. For some applications, multi-factor authentication cannot be used. For those applications, there is a special password generated. We don't need that at this moment. Click done. So, now we want to log in for this user. Stay signed in. No. And here he is in the beautiful Azure portal with the new home screen. So, that is how we can enable multi-factor authentication for one single user. If you are a small organization and you only have a couple of users that need to log in to the Azure portal, you can use this method. It's quite easy to enable this for a small set of users. If you need to enable this for multiple users, for example, you want to enable multi-factor authentication for all the users in your organization, that's actually my recommendation, especially if you're also using Office 365 and those users need to enter their credentials in Office 365. We can do it on a different way. If you want to enable multi-factor authentication for multiple users, the best way is to enable a conditional access policy. In order to do so, let's go to conditional access. Let's click on new policy. We can assign it to all our users, to all the apps in which they want to log in. We grant them access, but we require multi-factor authentication. And we can leave this one empty. enable policy, create. Ah, we forgot to give it a name. MFA for all users. Let's click on create. Now the policy is enabled. There are some other things that I want to show you. If you go to the Azure Active Directory and hit the MFA button in your security, we can go to additional cloud-based MFA settings, multi-factor authentication settings. If we go there, we can set some settings. For example, what methods there are available for the multi-factor authentication. Well, in this case, users can receive a call, as you just saw. They can receive a text message. They can receive a notification on their phone using the Authenticator app from Microsoft. All kinds of options. But what I actually want to show you is this one. Remember multi-factor authentication. Allow users to remember multi-factor authentication on devices they trust. So if I say I trust this laptop and I enable the setting, I only have to enter the second factor once in 14 days. So that can be quite interesting for users that have a trusted device, a device that is paired to them, for example, the laptop. So they only have to use their multi-factor authentication once in the 14 days. They will not get bothered with a second factor at every sign-in they do. So with that, let's end this demonstration. So in the Azure vlog, you saw how we can enable multi-factor authentication. I cannot say it enough. It's really important for accounts that hold administrative permissions to enable multi-factor authentication. It is really easy and it's not that priceful. I believe you can get a Azure AD P2 license today for, I thought, $12 per month. So that's not enough of money compared to the amount of security that you get for it. So enable multi-factor authentication for all your accounts that have administrative permissions in your organization. Please do it. I hope you found this Azure vlog interesting. If so, please hit the thumbs up button. And of course, subscribe to this channel and also hit the notification bell so you will receive a message once I have uploaded a new Azure vlog. So, with that, I hope to see you in the next one. Bye!